The most important thing to know, if you only know one thing, is that disaster robots make the disaster go away faster. My name is Robin Murphy. I'm a professor of computer science and engineering at Texas A&M, and I work with disaster robots. 1995, the Oklahoma City bombing happened. One of my grad students went up and helped, and he came back and said, "We've got to do it differently. We could have had robots like are being designed to go to Mars, to get into places where people and dogs can't go." What we're talking about are robots, either ground, aerial, or marine robots, that can help responders do things that they can't do any other way. And so in 1995, we all started working toward disaster robots. It was 2001 before we actually used one. That was the first use of ground robots for disaster. It's the ability to do things you couldn't do any other way. They needed to get more than 18 feet into the rubble. Robots can go into these places to get to where there might have been survivors. If I can see what I need to see, I can make good decisions to keep the responder safe. So this is the part where we make fun of me for driving. So notice that right now I'm driving heads up, but really the trick of a robot is to get beyond visual line of sight, because that's really the point. Disaster City is one of the emergency management complexes that Texas A&M has. It's designed to test and to train search and rescue teams on how to conduct search and rescue missions. We've supplied robots for 28 disasters. Earthquakes, Hurricane Harvey, we assisted with the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear accident. When we go, we bring robots and people that we've tested and practiced with in our training exercises. One of the biggest challenges to doing work in rescue robotics is not the robotics, it's the everything else. You're going to a different world. It's really challenging to be at a disaster. There's a physiological and psychological impact of that. It really takes quite a toll. So you have to be really good at what you're doing. But my job is so incredibly fulfilling. It's about the science and the technology and the way it could be used for societal good. That's a big deal to me.